Welcome back to the Budget Gamer Channel. Today we're going to be taking a look at The Adventures of Bertram Fiddle, Episode 1. Now, if you've heard of this game or you've played it before, you realize that it was released a while back, but it recently came to the Switch and now it's on sale for 50% off. And this actually was my first experience with the game. The Adventures of Bertram Fiddle can be classified as a point-and-click detective-style game with certain horror elements. But as both the goofy renderings and the character dialogue generally keep the themes very light, you can expect that the horror elements are merely elements of the plot and not really meant to scare you. The overall story being that Bertram Fiddle is kind of an off-the-wall, buffoonish detective who stumbles through the Victorian era trying to catch a killer. Initially starting the game, we come across Bertram as he wakes up in his bedroom, getting used to the character controls and the general point-and-click nature of the game. But the driving force behind his move from adventurer to detective lie within the early game confrontation wherein his wife demands he either find his new adventurer or get a job. And upon finally finding the key to unlock his own front door from the inside, he stumbles out into the streets, colliding with someone, resulting in a bag mix-up with the actual killer himself. And it's this attempt to get his puppy carrier back from the infamous murderer Jeff that lead him on his bumbling path through the rest of the game. The game itself, though, is divided into four chapters, taking between 15 and 30 minutes each to beat. As with all point and clicks, the general gameplay focuses around solving puzzles or using logic to get your way out of certain situations. And in the case of The Adventures of Bertram Episode 1, these puzzles or puzzle elements are present in every single scene. However, the puzzles themselves are generally very simple to reason your way through and don't take very many items to resolve. The game actually works to reinforce this simplicity and ensure the player's proper progression by limiting their backward progression to areas that no longer have anything to unlock. And though this does ensure that the player won't be scouring empty areas, it does make the game feel just a little too scripted. As you can probably tell so far, the visuals in this game are incredibly high quality, as are the voiceovers. And the uniqueness in the characters' voices along with the puns do help to keep a light air in the game. However, puns and reference humor in nearly every single possible dialogue action possibly cause a little bit more cringe than they do laughs. But overall, if you take the game as more of a Saturday morning cartoon than a serious puzzle adventure, it is pretty funny. However, Bertram and his puns aren't alone in this adventure to catch the anonymous killer, as the main antagonist in the game is actually Sherlock Holmes himself. And though there are only one or two interactions with Sherlock Holmes and his partner Dr. Watson throughout the gameplay, the Mr. Bean-like bumbling tomfoolery versus the learned crassness of Sherlock Holmes is very well established as the good guy bad guy dynamic, which generally puts dumb luck in a head-to-head race against education for the win at the end of the game. And as this is about a 1 or 1.5 hour short point-and-click adventure, there's really not that much more to cover. Whether you're playing the game because you're a fan of the graphics or the witty dumb puns and dad jokes, or whether you're playing it because you're a fan of those more simple point-and-clicks, it's probably going to at least be a somewhat enjoyable experience. But if you're not new to the genre of point-and-click adventures or the detective-style games, The Adventures of Bertram Fiddle is definitely not going to challenge you. But overall, as a casual, lighthearted handheld point-and-click, it might actually be a pretty decent gateway into the point-and-click adventures if you've never really been a fan. But anyway, that about wraps up the review of The Adventures of Bertram Fiddle for the Nintendo Switch. So if you enjoyed the review or found it helpful, feel free to throw me a like or a comment to show your support. And don't forget to click that little bell icon when you subscribe to stay updated with the latest content. And if you are enjoying this channel but you just want a little bit more or want to know what I'm doing or maybe what I'm covering next, the Budget Gamer channel is now on Twitter. But as a general side caveat, I have no idea what I'm doing on Twitter, so I'm just going to be updating my feelings, thoughts, what games I'm going to be covering, initial reactions, and first thoughts, as well as some general nerdy photos about the other side of my gaming life. So if you're interested, check us out on Twitter, and don't forget that we do have an Instagram as well. But anyway, this has been Budget Gamer, so as always, thanks for watching.